It's five big British bands that failed in North America. I'm John Beaudin. This is Rock History Music. It's always been a huge accomplishment for singers to make it in North America and cross that milestone, but it doesn't always happen. There have been many great talents in the UK. Obviously, some of the biggest bands in the history of rock are from the UK, but there are some whose dreams never seem to have crossed over. Our first, Take That. The current lineup consists of Gary Barlow, Howard Donald, and Mark Owen, but the original lineup also included Robbie Williams and Jason Orange. The band was signed to an American record label in 1995 with hopes of breaking the US market. But unfortunately, the group started to fall apart. With Robbie Williams leaving, he decided to work on some solo material. He seemed to have more success with the crossover with singles like Millennium and Rock DJ. So Take That broke up in 1996, but ended up reuniting in 2005. Keep in mind, all eight of their studio albums have charted either number one or number two in the UK, with over a dozen top 10 singles, including Everything Changes, Why Can't I Wake Up With You, and Love Ain't Here Anymore. The Jam. Here's a group with huge success in the UK, big part of British culture, and were considered one of the all-time greats. The punk mod revival band formed in the 1970s with Paul Weller on bass and lead vocals, guitarist vocalist Steve Brooks, and drummer Rick Buckler. In the early 80s, they couldn't release a song without it being a huge hit. They had a lot of those, including their UK top 10 hits, The Eton Rifles, Going Underground, Start, and A Town Called Malice. These hits never charted in America. In 1982, Paul Weller ultimately left to form another band that did not cross over to the North American charts, The Style Council. To date, he's released at least 17 solo albums, but again, not one North American hit, though he's a superstar in the UK. Girls Aloud. This band was way up there in popularity with girl bands in the UK. It was comparable to the Spice Girls, but unlike the Spice Girls, they did not have US stardom. Girls Aloud was an English-Irish pop group that was created on the ITV talent show Pop Stars: The Rivals in 2002. The group comprised of Cheryl Cole, who's become quite a media personality, Nadine Coyle, Sarah Harding, Nicole Roberts, and Kimberly Walsh. They had 20 top 10 singles in the UK before breaking up in 2009, and then having a reunion between 2012 and 13. They had hits like Sound of the Underground, No Good Advice, and Life Got Cold. Band member Nadine Coyle was comfortable with the success in the UK and didn't feel that they had to start from scratch. But group member Cheryl Cole wanted more, paired up with will.i.am for some music, but still US stardom wasn't there. Though she is, as I mentioned, well known as a media personality in North America. On August 26, 2020, Harding stated that she had been diagnosed with breast cancer that advanced to other parts of her body. In March of 2021, she said the disease was terminal and she wouldn't see another Christmas. She died on the morning of September 5th, 2021. She was 39. Generation X. They were a punk group formed in London in 1976. The band consisted of Billy Idol, Tony James, Bob Andrews, and Mark Laff. They had a five-year run and were quite successful in UK standards, with its self-titled first album peaking at number 29 and their hit single King Rocker hitting number 11 in 1979. But that same year, the band broke up. Andrew and Laff left. Idol and James brought in Terry Chimes as a replacement drummer and guitarist James Stevenson. The new lineup retitled itself Gen X until 1981. Billy Idol was not only responsible for forming the group, but he was the only one to have massive success in the US with songs like Eyes Without a Face, Money Money, and Cradle of Love. And of course, White Wedding. Slade, formed in Wolverhampton in 1966, they were big on the glam scene, or glam rock scene as some people call it. The band, Noddy Holder, vocals, guitar, and bass guitar. Dave Hill, guitars, vocals, and bass guitar. Jim Leah, bass guitar, vocals, keyboards, violin, and guitars. And Don Powell on drums and percussion. They are remembered for the 1971 hit, 'Cause I Love You. The following year, Take Me Back Home, Mama We're All Crazy Now. 1973, Come On and Feel the Noise, Squeeze Me, Please Me, and Merry Christmas, Everybody. In 1975, Slade moved to the United States to work on their live shows, but even that did not give them the momentum they needed, even though they're well known in North America. Many have heard their song Merry Christmas Everybody from Doctor Who, and the fans who really know that Come On and Feel the Noise was by Slade first, not Quiet Riot. Hill and Powell formed Slade 2 in 1993. Later, they shortened the name to Slade. And even though the band has transitioned over the years, Hill and Powell, at the date of this writing, are still the original makeup Slade today. all bands that worked really hard, and there are so many that didn't cross to the U.S. market. We plan on doing more of these shows for different countries, big bands in their own country, not so big in North America. And we're going to be working on a great feature on Canadian bands that never crossed over. Comment, give us some ideas in the comment section. Click that bell notification so you don't miss anything. Make sure you subscribe and share our videos. I'm John Beaudin. This is Rock History Music. Take good care of yourself.